In this video, I will show you how to convert any audio into MIDI in Reaper, just like this. I'll be showing you a very simple way to do it, a more precise way to do it, and an amazing custom action that you can build to do all of this in one click to any item in your session. Let's go. First, I'll show you the most straightforward way to do this. Let's say that we have an audio like this, and we want to turn this into MIDI, and it's super simple. All we need to do, go to the track effects and load Reatune. And in here, I'm gonna change the window size to about 50 and overlap to about 8x. You're free to play around with these settings. I just find that these work best for this situation. And then you're gonna check this box at the bottom that says Send MIDI events. This is gonna make it so it outputs the MIDI note that it's detecting in Reatune. And you can even try it for yourself. If you connect your guitar or any other instrument and load a piano after Reatune and then hit record. But I honestly wouldn't use this live. I think there are better things out there for this. Lastly, after checking these spots, you will close Reatune and go to the item, right click on it, and select Apply Track Take Effects to Items as New Take MIDI Output. And when you click that, you will notice that it's gonna give you all the MIDI notes of the item. Hey, if you're wondering what theme I'm using the Reapertips theme. And yes, I made this, I'm very proud of it, and you can get it in the description below, and it's free. Now, here's a real life situation where I use this feature a lot. So I have this section that needs bass. And usually I would just make a MIDI item and do all of my MIDI bass programming in here, and that takes a lot of time. And something I've been doing is using this same track to record my guitar, pretending that I'm a bass player. So pretty much I'm running my guitar through the same effects chain that the bass guitar will go. So the bass amp, the equalizer and all of that. So I'm gonna press record and I'm gonna play all of the bass lines that I want for this section on my guitar. And I'm gonna make sure to play each note really loud and clear so the conversion is more accurate. Dynamics don't matter, technique doesn't matter, just focus on getting the timing and the notes that you want. Okay, now that I recorded my guitar, all I need to do is right click and select my custom action audio to MIDI, and this is the result. You may wonder how I did all of that in just one click. Don't worry, later in this video I'll show you this incredible trick that you can do with this. Pretty good. So yeah, that's amazing. I was able to get pretty much all of the bass notes correct right away, and all I need to do is just fit some of the timings and do some legatos, and I have this action to do legatos real quick. I highly recommend setting this to a shortcut, set note ends to start of next note. And now I'm gonna show you a couple of issues that you may encounter and how to solve them. One is the timing. You will notice that everything is slightly late, and it's because of the window size of Reatune. One simple solution is just simply holding Alt and moving it until you see it, right? And let's actually move this into a track that has a piano so we can hear it. Okay, so the timing is mostly correct, but we have another issue, and it's these tiny notes that happen every now and then. So we're gonna open this in the MIDI editor, and you will see in the toolbar, there's this filter icon. You're gonna hit that, filter events, and check this spot to show only events that pass the filter. So you're gonna select event type note and the length to about 132. So these are all your tiny notes, and you can simply select all of these or just use set selection and hit delete. And now you just need to uncheck these spots and you will see all of your notes cleaned up. A quicker way to do this is going into the actions menu and make sure that you are in the main section and search for 132 delete. So when you run it, It's gonna get rid of all these tiny notes. Now, lastly, you can quantize this by hitting the quantize button, and you can play around with the settings, but these are mostly correct. So that's perfect. Now, there's a couple of things that we can do to get more accurate results, like applying some effects before reattune, and also applying some effects to the item itself. First, I like to insert JS time adjustment delay. Remember how every time we run the thing, it was a little bit late? We can compensate by adjusting the delay amount by negative numbers. So that's gonna make it so the MIDI just shift back and it aligns better with the audio. And I find that if you use a window size of 50, a good number to use in here, it's minus 25. You can play around with this. I find that minus 25 gets the best result so far. Now, really important, this one goes before reattune. In fact, all of the effects I'm gonna do now are gonna be before reattune. Another thing I like to add before reattune is re-EQ. And basically, we're gonna cut all of the bass from here. And we're gonna also emphasize the mid-range. I don't know, I find that it works better to detect the root note this way. Something like this should look good. So yeah, we're basically trying to clean the audio as much as possible so reattune can perform best. And lastly, I like to add re-gate before reattune. And this is to prevent all of the noises. In here, we can set a pretty low threshold, set the attack to 0, hold to about 50 milliseconds and release like that. And that's it for effects. Now, you're not gonna be doing all of this every time you wanna do audio to MIDI. So all you need to do is just right click and go to effects change and save all effects as a chain. So now every time you wanna do this, all you need to do is just right click and search for your effects change audio to MIDI. And it's gonna load all of those plugins in order. Lastly, there's a couple of things that we can do to the item itself. And one of them is normalizing by hitting Shift, Control, or Command, and. And this helps a lot, especially if your signal is pretty low. And another thing, especially if you're doing guitars or anything with very low notes, is increasing the pitch by octaves. So I would usually raise this by 1 octave or 2 octaves. And the way I'm doing this is by holding Shift, Alt, and you can adjust the pitch. Another way is double clicking and adjusting the pitch right in here in this spot. And that's it. All you need to do now is right click on this and hit your apply track, take effects to items to get your MIDI notes. And you will see that most times you'll get a much better result this way. And of course, I have a way to do all of this automatically with a crazy custom action that I will show you next. And now for my final trick, I'll show you a way to do all of the things I just showed you in just one click. All I need to do is just select this item, right click on it, and press this audio to MIDI button, and boom, it just, in 1 second, I get all of this MIDI, and it's very accurate and very useful right away. And here's the original. So yeah, I super love this, and I've been using it a lot to mostly get my guitar into MIDI and then turn that into program bass. This gives me a lot of times a solid starting point. The way I'm doing this is with a custom action. And to do that, we go to the actions list, and in here, new action, new custom action. By the way, for this technique to work, you're gonna need the SWS extension installed. If you don't have that, check the description below, it's pretty easy to install. We're gonna name this audio to MIDI. And for reference, here's what the final custom action is gonna look like. It's all of these actions, and it might look like a lot and just so much, but don't worry, I'm gonna walk you through each of these steps and explain what's going on so you can further customize it to whatever you need. And just as a reminder, the way you build this is by searching the name of the action in here. For example, pitch all takes up 1 octave. The first one, you click and drag into here. The next one will be select only track with selected items, and you will see it in here, and then just click and drag. Just make sure that you follow this order for this to work. Now I'm gonna demonstrate what each of these actions is doing and the purpose behind all of them. First, we got pitch all takes up 1 octave, and I do this because most of the times I'm doing guitars and low tuning stuff, so the low notes usually struggle with reattune, and pitching it up helps a lot. Next, we have select only track with selected items, and this is just selecting the track. Then it's going to insert a new track below, and this track is where we're going to do all of the processing. Next, we're going to move that item down into that new track. Next, we need to select the new track because we want to insert this effects chain that we made earlier. Now, if you try to find your effects chain in here, for example, have my audio to MIDI, you will not see it in here unless you do this little hack that you can do. If you go to your effects browser, you will see in the effects chain section, you will see all of your effects chains. And one way to get it so it shows up in your actions menu is by setting a shortcut to them. So for example, I can right click on this one and hit create shortcut and then just set any shortcut. I'm just going to do a very random shortcut, and then you will see that it will show up in your action list. So it says insert effects chain, quick master chain. So now it shows up in here. So that's how I able to have my audio to MIDI effects chain in my actions menu, and I'm able to use it as a step in the custom action. So running this will insert the effects chain we made earlier to do the audio to MIDI. Next, it's gonna normalize the item, and then it's gonna transform it into MIDI by running this action. After that's ready, it's gonna switch into the previous take, and it's gonna reset the pitch and reset the item take gain. Then it's gonna go to the next take, which is the MIDI. It's gonna put this back into the original track. It's gonna delete all of the tiny notes, and it's gonna transpose it down an octave because earlier we pitched it up one octave, so we're bringing it back to the original tune. And lastly, it's just gonna remove this track, and that's it. So yeah, now when I run this custom action, all of the things you see in here are gonna happen in less than a second. By the way, if you're wondering how I'm right-clicking and being able to have these actions over here, it's super simple. Just go to the actions menu, and you will see menu editor, and this will open up. And in here, you just need to find media item contents. And in here, you can add whatever you want, and you can even modify and tweak all of the things that you see in there. So for example, I just go and find my custom action, and I bring it over here by selecting it. And then I go right click, and I can use an emoji in here. So I'm just gonna do any speaker audio to MIDI. And I'm gonna hit apply, and now this will show up in my right click menu. So yeah, it's a very convenient way to have all of the actions you usually use on items to have them available in your right click menu. And that's it. I hope that was as useful as it is for me. This has seriously saved me so much time, especially for bass. Sometimes I will have a melody in my head and I would just sing it into the microphone and get that into MIDI and just play around with different synthesizers and stuff like that. It is a very, very fun thing to do. See ya!